We're at Long Beach in California, near Los Angeles, and came by light rail and enjoyed that. And there's a lot of just sitting there in the shade and everything else. And it's quite a nice little spot here. And we can look around and see some boats. And in the background we see the Queen Mary.
Be a celebrity hotspot here too, guys, but the paparazzi kind of pushed them away off this one. And then up ahead, guys, you're gonna have the Saddle Ranch. Now the Saddle Ranch, guys, is the owner, Dwight Yoakam, the country singer, would be the owner to the Saddle Ranch. To your right hand side, they have a mechanical bull there. You gotta be 18 years or older to ride the bull. Shopping bags, guys. It's really just an advertisement for the companies to have the store out here. Yeah. Ralph Lauren to your left, Lacoste to your right, Max Mara.
We're at Union Station in Los Angeles, and here's at Alameda Street, and here's the main station, all built Spanish Don, 1939, and this is the 75th anniversary of the building of that station.
Cars here, yeah. Very nice. Santa Fe, yeah.
Here we have a Santa Fe, or should I say, BNSF freight coming through Flagstaff, Arizona. Here we are at the Grand Canyon, and there's Lottie walking down the trail, and we get a gradual view around the canyon itself. We see a tree standing on magnificent place here, and we see right down here to the rock, and we see people walking along the trail. I'm at the Grand Canyon Railway Station, at the Grand Canyon itself, and just looking around at the station, and it's right near some of the lodges, and the Altova and the Right Angel and so on. There's the steam engine, etc. Let's take a circular look. Just another aspect of the canyon. Just another aspect of the canyon. Pretty stunning. It's when you look down, I don't want to even get any closer. It's the kind of thing that makes you think, well, no wonder some people fall off. And here's Lottie taking a picture. And it's really enough. Frankly, it's enough to make your heart race. It's just scary. This is the Grand Canyon train railway line. And here's a train that includes four dome cars. It's quite rare today, including this great dome and an observation car. There's the second train, And I noticed it's got a couple of former Bud RDC cars, including this one we're looking at, that have been demoted and now are like a muddy hole. This is the Southwest Chief coming into Flagstaff from Los Angeles. And we're about to board that and go to Chicago.
Separated a long way. Triple headed. No, quadruple. Double stack container.
There's the Southwest Chief at Albuquerque, New Mexico. Have around 20 minutes here. And Audie's standing there. Instead of shopping, right? You should be shopping here. They've got Indian wares and jewelry and the like on sale on the platform. Where they fuel up the locomotive. And they used to bring a washing machine on a big truck along here into the windows, but I'm not sure they're doing that today.
There
we go.
Okay. We're Minnesota that we're going to
up in New Mexico. And here's the train just crawling through this country. In the dining car, as you can see, okay, everybody's see there, the dining car. Okay, hello. We are at Union Station in Chicago. I'll give you a quick view of the main, or one of the main rooms here for the station, and it's very fine with columns and a nice floor and ceiling and so forth. Lounge in Chicago Union Station. There's a lot of working on the computer, and it's for sleeping car passengers only. It's quite nice here, and away from the hustle and bustle of the city, and yet we get taken out and shown our train at 9 o'clock, and we board for Cleveland. The Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in Cleveland, Ohio.
Until I kissed you, the Everly Brothers. So ladies and gentlemen, would you please greet the Doors? People seem to think you're from San Francisco. Is that true?
No, actually, we got together in L.A. We play in San Francisco a lot.
That's the explanation of why you have that association. Why is so much happening in San Francisco?
You figured it out yet? The West is the best.
There's Niagara Falls. We are now on the California Zephyr going through the Colorado Rockies.
The river out on the left, and you see some white waters. This gives you an idea. If you just to repeat this scene over a few million years, you can see how this canyon was carved over time.
This is Gore Canyon. It's magnificent country here.
As you can see, Gore Canyon is somewhat of a bottleneck. If you wanted to build a railroad to the west from Denver, you had to come through here if you were going to make it. And in fact, there was almost a railroad war here. So there were two different railroads wanting to head west back 150 years ago. And the two railroads were trying to do each other in, and what they did was tried to propose that a dam be built across Gore Canyon that would pretty well keep a railroad from coming through here. The government was all for this until they learned that one of the dam designs didn't have any connection to the water turbines that was supposed to be used to generate power. And the other design was for a location where you couldn't hold any water back anyway.
Oh, yeah.
Once he heard what shenanigans were going on here, like he canceled the plans for that, and the railroad was able to go ahead and come through the canyon here. As you can see, the railroad runs right along the edge of the river, and the river is fairly active today. We've had a lot of rain, and so there's a lot of white water to see here.
Mm-hmm. Spectacular. Look at that. You might see some rafters. Yeah, still a long way to go. And straight up in the mountains there. And the river. There we go.
Now coming up on the left, you can see, looks like 1, 2, 3, 4 are pretty good sized rafts full of people there.
Eastbound, California Zephyr.
Now coming up on our right, across the river, pretty soon you can see a dead tree with a disc. In fact, it's this one right here. Look, keep an eye out for bald eagles. Now I don't see anybody home right now.
About 25 or 30 minutes from now. Reno, Nevada.
We are at Reno, Nevada, what they call the trench. And the trains are underground, in a sense, below ground level, I should say, for a couple of miles here. There's the train. You go upstairs to the street level and all the casinos.
The famous Donna Lake.
The miniature Lake Tahoe.
On the right side of the train below is the lake formed by glaciers during the last ice age. We know it today as Donna Lake. On October 31st, 1846, heavy snows near the east end of the lake halted an immigrant party led by George Donner. The party had departed from Illinois in the spring of that year after falling victim to ill-advised detours and suffered other delays in Donner County Pilot South attempting to cross the Sierra during an early severe winter. While most of the party remained trapped at the lake, several members struggled through the snow to obtain help at Sutter's Ford in Old Sacramento.
Gotta love that song.
It's Roseville, California.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's going to take us approximately 25 minutes. 25 minutes, our next station stop, the city of Sacramento. That would be a good time. Check around your seat, check in your room, make sure you have all your personal belongings.
California Railroad Museum, and here's the toy model lamps. There we go. There we go. The California State Railroad Museum shop and entrance here. People just lining up to look at the museum and so on. That's a 1915 San Francisco World's Fair, I guess it was, the engine, 15-inch gauge. And plenty more inside as well. So in the morning, 7:30 in the morning, just a quick look at the lounge. In the forests at the moment. This is Klamath Falls, Oregon, I remember. The Coast Starlight, and here's the train. Just get a quick look at that, and we can get some more views of the scenery and the like along the way. It's been quite nice. And we've got the two lounge cars on here and the dining car. There's a picture of Lottie taking pictures of this train and so forth. The station. This is the Pacific parlor car. Coast Starlight, and we got a train going out there on the side there, by the way. Right now, Union Pacific.
Why? I'm going to Amtrak.
Oops, okay, sorry.
Back by us.
A lot of people coming in for breakfast in the dining car, which is the next car. And there's also an additional lounge car in here as well. Looking at the scenery, but enjoying the Wi-Fi.
No, that would be silly.
There we go. Anyway.
What are you going to do?
Oh, I know. All right. Okay. All right. Okay. All right. A couple of historic rail cars in there. I missed some, but there's a Pacific Railroad Preservation Association car. They're approaching Portland. Thank you.
There's one of the cascades coming in. This will be from Seattle, we're at Portland, Oregon.
The Columbia River. Nice trestle bridge there.
Mom, you got one? Yeah.
We're on Puget Sound on the way to Seattle, and we see an island over there. We go around the corner here and follow the water. You can even see the train, but we just go around the corner. You hear the train? Thank you. Bridge is 6,000 feet long. There you go, it's a long bridge. We're looking up into it now as we go underneath. There we go. That's nice. There's a speedboat. And we look across and around. We see the passengers taking photos here. You know, there's one right there. There she is. And the people, others in the dining car. And that's what they get, the view you get on this train. They're just approaching Tacoma, Washington. There's a BNSF freight in the background, four engines by the look of it, and some freight cars. There's our light rail and maintenance and storage in Seattle. We're on the train to SeaTac Airport. Swing around and we get Lottie and over there and I, and there we go. Okay. We're just leaving SeaTac Airport. It's one of the terminals that the Alaska Airlines planes hold. Heard of them, let's say. Background. So we're on the light rail and heading back towards downtown Seattle. A lot of this track is elevated, so it's an interesting run. Let's go that way. There is a bus depot.
Well, I was in Vegas.
And workshops.
You sent me a picture of the Eiffel Tower and I sent you a picture of the
depot. Yeah. And there's the tracks leading down into the depot.
Yeah. We're in the monorail in Seattle, heading towards the Space Needle. Sorry about that, folks. Drop the camera.
This is the Seattle monorail departing for downtown from the Space Needle. Builder leaving Seattle, and to get a rear view as we're rolling along. Freight about to come by here. BNSF. That's the view you get from the rear door on the Empire Builder. Later on flight Caltrain. Washington on the Empire Builder. Quite spectacular country in this area. A little town with, we're not stopping at, we're passing through. We're up at the Glacier National Park in Montana, and here's a couple of historic Ford buses that were built in 1930, up to 1936, the one you're looking at. And we're going to go away for a 4-hour tour, so a quick look around this park station, let's say. This is at the Lake McDonald Lodge. You see a couple of jammers, and we've even got some right round here, so they're very, very popular.
That's Birdwoman Falls. It's about 500 feet high. There's a lake above there. You can't see the lake from here. It's one of those high alpine lakes. And as we go further on, you'll see there's lots of snow back in that gap. The sedimentary lines in the rock really easy right now. Look at the snow above Birdwoman Falls. That's an amphitheater in there.
Here we are in the Glacier National Park, and we see up into the mountains. There's a peak solid rock boat over there. It's a kind of information center and the like. A little animal running down there. I don't know what that is. Here he goes. Hello. Hello. There you go. Well, that's some rapids in the park. Just give you an idea of what the water's like. As it rushes over there. And lots of colors in the water, like a turquoise color in here. And everybody's been having a look at it on the bus
but
tour.
But that didn't kill her. She went all the way down to Lake McDonald. She found her on the side of the lake.
Essex, Montana, and has a train, and I'm getting a picture of the hotel where he's staying, the Isaac Walton Inn, as they call it, and that's where we're staying overnight tonight, and it's got cabooses and a locomotive over here, which is converted into a room for accommodations. Okay, so I might take a couple of pictures here and a few videos. Here comes a BNSF freight. And the light's coming the wrong way, you might say, but still, here we go. Heading east. Here comes a westbound freight through Essex, Montana. Getting a little late now in the evening. You get out of our very bedroom in that hotel, and we're heading off tomorrow on a sleeping car to Minneapolis. So that's it for today. Now this is Amtrak train number 8, the Empire Builder, arriving in Essex, Montana, ready to take us to Minneapolis, Minnesota. There's my wife, excited to get on the train. We have left the real mountainous region now and heading across the... We'll be heading into the plains and everything shortly, but the train left a little late, but it's a very enjoyable train ride, and back to you later.
Thank you.
train here at St. Paul, and look down towards Union Station here, where we got off the train from Essex. This is inside the Mall of America, the largest shopping mall or shopping center or whatever in the United States. There's 520 shops on about four levels. And we got the roller coasters and whatever up in here as well. So there you go. There's a green line train in heading towards Minneapolis. Well, it's the 7th of August, and we're staying at the Warfields in home in Ten Strike in northern Minnesota. And just a quick view around in the house. They have the lake here, and this is the log cabin by the lake. They have the main house up the hill a little bit, and we arrived very late. In fact, it was about 2:30 in the morning. So here's just a quick view of the interior there, and here's the lady of the house, Lottie. Enjoying, so it's just really wonderful. Anyway, there we go. Okay. So this is just finished a paddling around the lake, and nice sunny day here, and everyone's having a good time. No, none of that. Okay, guys, well, anyway, we're on the former Northern Pacific branch line that used to go from Bemidji up to International Falls in Canada. Okay, so there we go, looking along the former right of way. We're at the Duluth Railroad Museum here, and it's really a good museum. And so-called Thomas the Tank Engine Day, which is take it or leave it. But there you go. Anyway, it's quite a very good railroad museum.
Sounds better if you echo me. So grown-ups, if you're not gonna dance, you gotta echo me. Alright? Got that echo. Whatever I say, you'll echo me. And the kids are gonna jump around on the guitars. Twist and shout.
Shout.
Come on, baby.
Baby.
We just stopped for a picnic lunch in Duluth, Minnesota, Got a nice park here. And here's everybody having their sandwiches and their picnic.
Hello.
Oh.
Good day.
Good day. Yeah, and there we are.
Good day, mate.
This is the Greyhound Bus Museum at Hibbing, Minnesota. We're in the Greyhound Bus Museum in Hibbing, Minnesota. And let's have a quick look at that. And there's Lottie listening to something over there on the history and so on. Just at the Warfields house on a little balcony there, we got a overlook to the yard and towards the log cabin where Lotta, Cheryl and I are staying. We're in the main house and looking over towards the lake and around. So we've got just at the back of the house, let's just say it's the back of the house here. So in the house.
It's Marshall's mom.
Oh,
yeah.
That guy?
Yeah, he's just a guy.
And that's his dad?
No, not dad. Just a guy.
Friend, yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, look at that. Huge. Yeah. Oh, my goodness. How old were they when they died?
She was 75.
Very young.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Very young.
Yeah.
Is he smoked too?
Yeah.
Oh, that's probably why. Because my dad died as well because, you know, smoking.
By the lake are having a picnic in Marshall Warfield's property, and there's a whole stack of people here going to enjoy that picnic when we get it underway. Well, here we are at with the barbecue out there in the forest, still going well, you know. Everybody's enjoying their lunch. This is not the place for a vegetarian, let me tell you. Going into its depot or workshops, etc. There we go. This is the Jefferson Lines bus coming in from Minneapolis, Minnesota, arriving here in Bemidji. Fish bake, a nice fish dinner in 10 strike.
Did you get tartar sauce, Eddie?
And some family and friends gathering here to enjoy the dinner. And you can actually see out here to the lake, they're right on the lake. Here we are at Bemidji, Minnesota. There's a little Dairy Queen where I had a little lunch snack, let's say, and there's everybody on this footpath and cycling in Bemidji, and here's the actual lake. It's one of the 10,000 lakes in Minnesota. Rather a windy day and fairly choppy. Here comes a freight train through Bemidji. I think it'd be Burlington Northern Santa Fe. Facing towards the current existing Burlington Northern Santa Fe coal line. So this is the right of way along here, heading towards Minneapolis. You see, we've got the Burlington Northern Santa Fe line right here, which we took a movie of a minute ago with a coal train. Any kind of luck, another one will come along. Somehow, I don't think so. This is the little town of Ten Strike, Minnesota, and we're in front of the post office. This is an old wooden building. There's a population here of only about a couple hundred people. So here's the post office. It's really like a log cabin from the Wild West days. There you go. There's everybody, the van and all the rest of it. Throwing a frisbee around at 10 strike. There you go. Yeah. There we go. Well, here we are having a little bit of a meal prepared by Lotter at the. The little the log cabin by the lake, and strike. I'm having a little Filipino meal here today.
There we go.
And we look at the lake over here as well, coming at about 7 o'clock at night. And it's quite nice out here.
It's all right.
Yeah. And continuing on there with the dessert that Otto's made. There are several different kinds of dessert. Getting stuck into that.
It's excellent. Oh gosh.
That's a lot anyway. That's a lot. That's thick.
Like sometimes I make a big one. There's a lot of veggies, or not veggies, I mean fruit.
Yeah.
So our seconds allowed here in this?
Mm-hmm.
All right, we're at the Tasker State Park in northern Minnesota. And here's the happy group. All smiling. And there we go. Well, here we are having a little picnic in the park, literally. And this is the car we came in, a little green machine, as they call it. And you just look around and there's people parked, you know, camping, tents, lots of nice trees. Right round like so, and there we go. Okay, we are at the headwaters of the Mississippi River here at Lake Itasca in northern Minnesota. And you recognize a few people here. Anyway, this is where people can actually walk across the Mississippi on these stones. Not that I think I'm going to do it, but there you go. At the town of Ten Strike, Minnesota, and it's only a population of 201 people. A little bit more now that we're visiting. And there's the town hall and the post office. And we just swing around and we get one of these buildings that's in the town, and there's everybody waiting for me to finish my little project, let's say. Just visiting the museum in Bemidji, and not a lot on transportation here, but there's a lot on history. And sports and culture and so forth here. Actually, we go through to the railroad section as well. May as well have a look at that. There's a model train layout. And plan to restore the Great Northern Railroad, which we're in right now. And the timetables and one that I've collected and so forth are available to the public. We have another view of the model railway that actually is running, incidentally.
If you were ever to
own
one of them, you'd be happy, right, Dad?
Yeah.
One of those old timetable things?
Yeah.
Be worth a lot of money, wouldn't it?
Yeah. We're just down by one of their friends' homes here, and having a look around, and Cheryl's going to learn how to water ski, and about ready to go out on the boat and do a bit of water skiing. So there you go. That's Jenny water skiing. Here's Andy doing a bit of skiing. Looking professional too. Wow. There you go. Yeah, we go, just slowly but surely. Cheryl's about to do her first ski. Now, there you go. Not good. Oh, well, never mind. Nope. Oh, well, second attempt didn't work. Never mind. Not too bad for a first go. Well, we're about to leave. We're leaving the dock for a little ride on the speedboat here. And Cheryl didn't quite make it on the skis at that stage, but we're heading off and going for a ride in the boat. Thank you.
jump in and swim a little bit.
Cruising the lake again yeah. on a
to make
it cruiser to cover for rather than a speedboat.
We're gonna leave you.
Jen, can you do bye-bye. An Uncle Ron swan dive?
Yeah.
You'd have to start paying for the mortgage right away, though, right?
You would. You'd have to get some rent on it, but it would break your back.
Right. I'd just be nuts to pay full front. I mean, I don't think they'd have 300 grand sitting in the bank account.
I'm sure Bird is going to move.
He wants to move.
Yeah.
Well, Bird, Bird's just living at Roger's place.
Oh, yeah. Really? Every weekend.
Pretty much.
Yay. Train running. Here's the talent show.
Bye.